Crying already, this is gonna be great.
You guys have some amazing fans. That's really beautiful. Well, sorry to give you a question right when you're crying, Tom.
I don't ever see that. I cry at insurance commercials. Flo is speaking the truth, man. I love you, Flo.
So Nikki and Tom, you know, well, you became a later addition to the friend group, I guess, for the guys.
Yeah, roommate.
But what are BMO and Thighs King, what are your favorite most shenanigans that you got into with Finn and Jake? What are your favorite memories of the show, moments that you had with those characters, Nikki and Tom?
Oh man, well, you know, when the I-King moved in with them, I thought that was funny, because it was like, I love when you take like these characters in this like super exotic, crazy land, and just do like dumb, banal sitcom crap. You know what I mean? You know, you're in the toilet seat up Ice King. Wow, what can I say? That's the stuff that really makes me laugh about this show, because the characters are deep, but they're all, you know, you can do really banal stuff in it. Kind of still matters, because that's what life is, a mixture of like high adventure and just boring shit, you know?
What about you, Nikki?
I love BMO being there, like, as a, sometimes like a little baby, so they're taking care of me, like, I think there's an episode, like, BMO, like, kind of hurt herself, and then she said, like, oh, please, kiss me on my face, and stuff like that. So that's cool, but at the same time, like, sometimes BMO really with these two, like, you know, Finn and Jake, much older than them now, older than her, or him. And then, yeah, so there's an episode that they are, like, Finn is her best time, so she's, like, really like, okay, Finn, it's your best time, you have to be naked, and then there's a lot going on, you have to be naked. So, kind of, yeah, I think the humor is really, like, fun to be around, and it's a, like, living being. Sometimes like she's talking about like, you know, being talking with the football, and when Finn and Jake wasn't there. Just there's so many different sides of BMO, so it's just discovering little by little. It's really fun.
That's awesome.
Did I answer your question?
This is beautifully.
Oh wait,
no. I was doing the BMO Noir episodes, you know.
Oh, that's amazing.
Yeah.
That was a challenge.
I
remember that record really well, because I'm not really an actor, I'm an artist. So I was so intimidated, you know, by Jake and John and Finn. And then I was always like dogging myself into the script. And then I'm just reading it, and then I say that I put it in my butt, and then they were both like, look.
Is that it spawned creators of so many amazing Cartoon Network shows. I think we actually have a fun, do we have a fun little graphic to show them? I was told we did. Maybe we don't. I'll keep talking.
I'll describe it.
So, you know, we've got... oh, there we go! So all these amazing shows, all these amazing creators have come from Adventure Time. I wonder if you want to talk a little bit about just all the people that have worked on the crew and the shows that they've been.
Individually, no.
One at a time.
We just got really lucky, I think, because Penn went after people who seemed like they had a really strong personal vision. So a lot of them would have made shows anyways, I'm pretty sure. We just kind of tried to steal some of their energy while they were on their set. Like vampires. But no, that's, I mean, and also the show kind of accommodates so many different tones and styles that I think it was easy to bring in people who were, had vastly different visions, because that was what the show was. So.
Yeah. I think it's a testament to the show that so many amazing people worked on it and gone on to make amazing things. It was sort of a reading ground for a lot of people, so there's something really special about that.
Yes.
So...
Are they hiring?
Many of you are here. series, it's so weird to say that, series finale of Adventure Time, The Ultimate Adventure. Adam, can you tell us a little bit about that? I think spoiler, obviously, but any little tidbits that you can give us?
Oh my gosh, what?
Can you tell us anything about the final episodes?
It's anything? Everything you want, except for the people who don't want the things that we want. Hard. I feel like, especially now, like when a show ends, there's so much pressure and so much expectation. It has to be so many things that, you know, you can kind of go crazy just trying to incorporate all that. So I feel like we found an ending that's satisfying without trying to answer every single question. But yes,
exactly.
I can tell that maybe was into that answer or thought it was.
Sometimes, I mean,